over to the casters as they're looking rather shady.
So, during the break, had a talk with Don Reichart, and you know, sort of lovely conversation, but unfortunately got told that Anders has to go. And so Moses is here joining us. Moses, what's up, bro? I'll drop the act. How's it going,
Anders, man? Anders has been taken care of.
Anders is, you know, yeah, he, you know, the thing is, it's a bit hot out here in the valley, and he decided to go and take a swim. So, you know, we'll see him later. Possibly, maybe, not.
Hopefully. You'd hope so.
But let's get into the game here, boys. It is the pistol round here on Overpass. G2 starting on the CT side, TyLoo starting on the T side. And so, I mean, do you agree with what Days was saying here about TyLoo coming into this match, Moses?
Yeah, a lot of the issues I see in TyLoo, it comes down to, you know, the experience of these players. Like I said, beating up on Chinese teams, and we've seen it with North American teams where you practice against lower quality, you develop some bad habits. And I don't think TyLoo, as individual players, have developed good habits to make the proper decisions in the heat of the moment when they need it. So, I mean, it's something that only experience can give you. So, I mean, obviously with their boot camp in Europe, being in North America for 2 weeks, actually, look at this one. Look at this push.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, and it was the perfect one as well. Shoxi, two quick, easy headshots for him. And he didn't even overcommit when he goes for it. Just the shoulder peek, it was too quick. That was some sexy play.
Yeah, and that's actually designed to punish that. Two players there, that has to at least be traded. So there's a big loss, and Shox is just going to continue the tear. That skill is shining at the moment. He's going to go for a fourth. He could even get all five.
And he will. Ace in the pistol round. And there you go. That's the kind of start that you're looking for G2. If you just got bodied by Immortals on Cobble, you wanted a good start here on Overpass.
It was a casual ace. I mean, outside of this, there was nothing really that spectacular, that flashy. Everything else from there is just kind of easy as it goes. But this is the, I mean, with two players sitting there, you punish that push, or you at least trade it. Attacker has to get that kill if they're caught off guard. But, I mean, it is Shox, to be fair. All fairness to TyLoo, it is Shox.
Yeah, right. That's one of the very best pistol players in the world. Monster in the pistol rounds. And so, well, there we go. G2 get that start. Leading 1-0 now after winning the pistol. And, well, just G2 style, man. Five SMGs across the board. They don't care if you buy Kevlar, if you're going to invest in the round. They're still going with the SMGs because, you know, they're French and they like their Skrilla.
Yeah, I mean, a big, big opportunity for them to get out to an economic lead early on. The tough part is if they lose too much, the reinvestment in M4s into the future round is going to be so difficult. So they do have to be a little bit cautious, especially against these Deagles. Scream's going to have a big job to do close up, because at range, these Deagles can be very dangerous against the SMGs.
Yeah, that's the tricky bit, you know, especially if you're playing in this position where you don't have to worry about long. There's going to be a lot of shots taken at you, although Captain Mo doing work right now. Two quick kills for him. RPK will stand the line over on the A site.
And this is some of that disorganization I just mentioned. I mean, look, the player with the bomb pushes up, thinking that the rest of his team is going to be committing to that bomb site after the initial success, and they actually fall back. So then when he dies with the bomb in that location, the rest of his team is stuck having to commit towards that A site, and it's just too disorganized in the mid-round. So those are the things that TyLoo kind of collapses as these rounds go on.
Yeah, we can't really see that kind of hesitation, especially from G2. I mean, Immortals completely dictated the flow of the game on Cobblestone. No hesitation whatsoever from them. They were just taking the fight to G2. If you, however, face off against G2 and are not conscious of your spacing, if you're just running in one at a time, they're going to shred you. It's just that simple.
The multi-kill potential of this G2 team is unreal. With Shock, Scream, I mean, those are two players who can get very quick kills and can adjust to a second one. RPK always steady as she goes. I mean, there's a lot of talent on this team that is going to outshine the TyLoo players, to be quite frank.
I'm not a very big fan of what Scream is doing here, just because he has a rifle, and he's the only one with a rifle, and now he's dropped that rifle. Why are you pushed up the top mid when you have three guys who are running SMGs, Scream? But okay then, whatever. They'll be able to recover the rifle, but still.
It can definitely get dicey, and that's the gun you don't want to drop away. That's the free money over towards TyLoo. Any advantage they can get in that regard would be huge. I imagine, yeah, 5 AK is going to come out for TyLoo. They're going to have the full kit. Not a whole lot of investment in those first rounds. They did have some upgraded weapons, but to have this many nades as well, pretty conservative in those first two rounds and how they decided to spend.
Well, it's worth mentioning that TyLoo are also a team that have suffered under the new Valve rule regarding coaches and their ability to lead in-game. Karsa was very involved on the tactic front, basically. He was doing a lot of the homework, obviously, preparing the team for their matches, but then he would also be very involved in the matches. And it feels like since that Valve ruling came in, we've seen TyLoo struggle. I believe it's come down to Fancy, you know, to actually call the shots now for the Chinese team.
Yeah, and this is actually, that's a very cool idea. If you notice, G2, they have plenty of money built up, and they actually didn't really invest in too many nades. I don't even think Shox had anything. I think Scream only had one or two, and Smith's himself only had one or two. That's because they're doing an aggressive tactic, so they don't need a whole lot of nades. SCTs, they're pushing up, and they just wanted to win or lose by the aim duels and saying, if we lose this, at least we haven't spent, you know, $1,200 on utility that's not going to get used, that we basically waste. So pretty cool idea from them, and it works out. 5-on-2 advantage. Even though they have some players low, there shouldn't be a whole lot of danger. One kill from Fancy. Can he get another one? He does recover onto RPK, but he can't land the shot. And leaves it all just down to Captain Mo.
Yeah, who's going to run into Shox in a moment. Shox has only got the 12 HP, though, so it's not ideal for him.
Headshot angle, though, which is nice.
Exactly. He is playing it intelligently, right? If you've got no HP, just play a headshot angle so you're dead anyways, right? Versus the AK, it doesn't matter. So we'll see if Captain Mo's going to work his way back over towards long. Shoxy going for the aggressive push right now, trying to get in behind to get that info. And well, with 30 seconds left, it really doesn't leave too many options here for Captain Mo. It looks like he's going to head down through connector towards that B site. And we still have RPK posted up at Toxic on B site, ready to watch short. So he's going to have so little time to play with here, unless he's just deciding to back
off. I think he's just deciding to save. I mean, okay, it's not the worst call in the world. Obviously, there's really not a whole lot you can do to win this round in this kind of a situation with the clock running down. The best you could have hoped for is, obviously, if you go towards B, you get that one kill, you can get a bomb plant, some extra bonus money. He just needs to be very careful. He obviously doesn't know that Shox is coming behind him. He's just got to be very careful that he doesn't lose this gun right at the end. And it just you could, like a horror movie, just dropping down at the last second.
Yeah, right. Surprise! Not quite. Now things get fun. Now you see G2 fully investing in the round as well. All of the nades, making good use of that bank. Four players with more than 5,000. That's a very good comfort zone to be in going into the fifth round. 4-0 lead for G2.
Yeah, only losing one player there for G2 is huge for this amount of money to have built up. And now, I mean, with that one AK save, you can see there's a small investment surrounding it. And actually, Fancy's not going to slow down whatsoever, right through the Molotov. Almost catching G2 off guard, but they just decide to bail out, feeling that pressure coming and don't even want to risk it. Mm-hmm. So they fall all the way back, and they're going to turtle up in the 8 bomb site. That's going to be Smiths and Scream doing that.
Nice angle there by Shoxy, straight into connector. Had there been anybody there, but it did do a little bit of damage, I think, to somebody. So still, TyLoo, after getting control of connector, they've worked their way back out into mid, and while G2 are playing very passively on A right now, they had the three players down on B, and so Scream and Smith's just holding from the site itself. Shoxy now rotating up to A, so there must be a feeling here, not having seen anything or gotten any info on B. It looks like they peaked Monster as well. There isn't a whole lot here to indicate TyLoo going towards B, so Shoxy wants to play it safe.
Yeah, Captain Moe's going to be all alone out towards long with the AK-47. A little bit of a bummer as well, because he's smoked off at the moment, so we can see nothing towards that A site. You can see he's just trying to spam through that smoke a little bit. But he's the one, I mean, with 45 seconds left, the only rifle, he's the one that has to kind of create something. They want him to be able to take a duel into this A site and at least get that one kill to provide the opening for the pistols to rush in and kind of swarm that defense.
So 40 seconds left on this clock, and G2 pretty firmly established now with the three players on the A site. Scream, Shoxy, and Smiths. Smiths peeking long, not going to see anybody. So it's all going to be about mid, and I think Smiths with that jump just barely saw the first man through. That guy exists no more. DD is dead, and Smiths and Scream just teaming up on him now. Smiths doing work. Another two kills for him. Well, basically ending the round on two. It was Scream who managed to pick up two as well in the melee there, but 5-0 lead now for G2, and they're looking comfortable, Moses. I mean, it's nothing like what we saw on Cobble from them.
Yeah, they haven't really been challenged whatsoever. Obviously, I mean, only one gun round really here for TyLoo. Their plan that round was Captain Mo with the AK out towards long. Hope he can get a pick off. Hope he can find some kind of duel there, see if he can win it. But G2 just plays it really disciplined, just back in the site. Don't over-peak, don't overextend. And I think that's what we're going to see out of G2 throughout the majority of this half. They know they have such an advantage in so many ways. They can just play a standard game and outlast TyLoo.
Oh, this is brutal. They aren't playing off the Molotov, per se, that was going to clear out short there. Had they gone for something aggressive in sewers, that might not have gone well. Scream going to catch them lined up and sprays down both. Attacker and Captain Mode both dead. Smith's in mid-restrooms, doesn't even need to really stick around for this. He is setting up that flash for Scream to go for the peak. I do like it. They're keeping their heads together here, the teamwork, but Smith will overextend, and now we're into a 3-on-3.
Yeah, Smith gets caught right in front of a Molotov. Didn't really feel like he could fall back and run all the way through it. Maybe too much damage. So commits to the fight, maybe hoping Scream would come up to help him out in a 2-on-1, but doesn't happen that way. It is equalized into a 3-on-3, and RPK and Scream are actually rotating back. They're hustling to get to this A site because they know how exposed it is at the moment with Scream having to fall back through the door. And actually, I mean, still in the mid-round, TyLoo doesn't seem like they've made a decision. I mean, they have 50 seconds left on the clock, so they have time, but they're letting somebody really probe into this site, and they're very split up. One in bathrooms. You just now have Fancy coming to meet up with his teammate. So this A bomb site is going to be under attack.
Very soon now as well. Somebody, there's the pop flash. That's going to open things up. The push is there, and Scream gets a bullet to the face already. RPK forced out into the open, needed to win that duel, and he's not. Fancy and somebody both teaming up on him. It's going to be Body, the last man alive here for G2. Luckily for him, he is coming through mid, however, but with that smoke down and really with the bomb down, TyLoo have just spread all out. So Triangle of Doom is about to get set up here on this A site. There really isn't too much hope here for Body.
Yeah, but with the money they have built up, obviously, I mean, this is a situation where you can't blame them for going for it. And there's a gap in the defense that gets exposed. Body, just an easy kill, not even looking that way as DD, but he cannot get the second one. And that's the thing. I mean, Body going for that isn't a bad idea just because they have so much money that if they can just take those AKs away, it's great. But TyLoo there, I mean, they get the benefit of the way the rotations worked after this aggression from Scream down these stairs, the way he had to fall back through the B bomb site and rotate over towards A. They just didn't feel comfortable coming out and trying to get better positions actually inside the site. They were playing from the choke points, and that gave TyLoo a lot of space to just slowly kind of work up and cautiously execute onto that site.
Well, they're not letting up on the aggression here, G2. I like it. Straight into connector again here for Scream. Smith's holding in mid. Three players over on the B site, and it's a 5-1 lead right now for G2 on the CT side. But with those three players on B, it looks like they were really trying to counter any kind of early aggression coming out from TyLoo. Perhaps TyLoo looking to change things up. It's not the case, but now RPK and Body, it's just aggression all over the place. They're going to go for the push, and Fancy is waiting in T-spawn. He's about to get rushed down here.
Yeah, what's the response going to be, though? Because it looks like Fancy knows this. He hears these footsteps, obviously. And actually, DD is burning. Shox finds Captain Mo, and there goes Fancy. So damage done to TyLoo all across the map. They knew it was coming, but they couldn't respond adequately. Nice aggression from G2, taking the fight to TyLoo. And oh, what a spam. Body jumping up. That's a nice kill. And it's quickly a 5-on-2.
Oh, that's sickening. And then Body gets out as well. Somebody too slow into sewers to get the trade. So it's somebody, an attacker. They're split up across the map now as well. They have no quick way to get to each other because somebody has no control over connectors. But there will be a 1-for-1 trade. He does eventually find RPK, only to get traded by Body. And Smith walks right around attacker. The timing! Attacker, he's got the bomb, and he might be able to get up onto the A site.
Yeah, he is. Obviously, he doesn't know it's clear, but this is incredible timing with it, of how that just worked with him and Smith. So a free bomb plant for TyLoo, perhaps, if he doesn't spend too much time trying to clear everything, because obviously, in his mind, he's thinking there's a defender somewhere. Surely this bomb site is not just going to be wide open. So eventually, he'll get the bomb planted. That'll be bonus money, but he's trying to secure his position just so he can make a play for the win at some point.
Now, if he can catch them overextending, Smith is taking his time. He's guaranteeing that attacker can't make it over too long. Attacker's going to catch Shox. He's just rushing up from CT spawn. Or from lower halls, and now it's Scream and Body rotating in. Luckily for them, though, they're buddied up, so there shouldn't be a possibility here of attacker picking off both. He does give his way away his position, rather, but he still manages to pick up a headshot on Scream. This is nuts now in a 1v2 winnable situation. Smoke goes down for Smith. He's going to be able to get onto the site. They both have kits here for G2, and it's all about attacker finding this next man, and it's not going to happen. He gets caught by Body. And it's going to be G2 actually holding on to it. But he did make it a very expensive round for G2.
Yeah, those extra two guns are going to be nice, just chipping away at the economy of G2, forcing some of those rebuys. Unfortunately, you can see, I mean, he's trying to make plays. You have to be a little bit mobile in how you're playing that kind of a situation in a one-on-four like that. So with the plant spot, he did kind of play himself out of the win no matter what. Even if he got that next kill, mm-hmm. I think the defuse would have came in either way.
Yeah, no, it's true. You're right. Smith managed to make it across onto the site just fast enough. I mean, this I'm assuming is a tactical pause being used here by TyLoo.
Yeah, you would believe so, which is going to be interesting just because it is one of those tactical pauses that comes out when they're going to be saving. Mm-hmm. They don't have the money to buy here. So talking things over, maybe that save run will be like an extra 30, 40 seconds. They can kind of chat things over and really get everything down. But like you said, I mean, hopefully this is that situation where they can get that coach involved. They were a little bit hurt by the ruling change to not have him as the in-game leader. So this is where they can get him involved.
Yeah, no, exactly. That was actually brought up. It's a bit of a topic, since the Asia Minor. How are TyLoo adjusting? There are certain teams that are struggling, definitely. Na'Vi is one of them as well, who's really taken the hit with Starks being limited. We saw that at E-League not too long ago. So, I mean, are they going to be able to make the adjustments necessary here to go up against the G2, who clearly feel very comfortable? Like, we're not really seeing G2 show them much respect here.
Yeah, and I mean that's the big thing, because I talked about this yesterday. One of the benefits that TyLoo's had is since they've been an unknown quantity, there's kind of two ways you can approach the game plan going up against a team you don't know how they're going to play. You can either play it very passively and see what they're going to throw at you, or you can be aggressive and play that no respect and see if they can even compete with you. And that gave TyLoo a lot of success early on. That's where those upsets come from, because early on they did play, the opponents were being that passive style. But now you can see Scream doesn't care anymore. Scream's doing the no respect. Four quick headshots and the ace. That's beautifully done. That is sick.
That's as clean as it gets. You know, he just has to sign that moment, and you know it. This is just Scream. Look at it. He's got 20 bullets in the mag, and it's all just so clean. He's in DM right now. You know, bot warm up. They're just running at him, and he's just clicking away. Okay, then, Scream. I mean, Shoxi with the pistol ace, now Scream with the anti-eco ace. I mean, how many aces can G2 hope to get here on this map?
That was sick, especially because, yeah, with just one clip of the M4, the silence, the 20 bullets, that's living up to his namesake.
Basically, you know, they talk about my one tap.
He's going to sell some mice.
Oh, well then. Okay, somebody. Well, got revenge for the last round. There's the headshot. Drop Scream. Smith's going to get caught way out. Unfortunately for him, somebody was crouching behind the playground over there, and so he's going to get dropped, and it's RPK and body now. Last two alive here for G2. And, well, this is the other side of it, right? They went for this kind of ultra-aggressive play in, what, the fourth round? And so didn't pan out this time. That's the long and short of it.
This is now going to be the danger if G2 continues this no-respect style, is that if they're going to get punished like that, their economy is going to run out quickly if they continue to have that kind of aggression that doesn't have success behind it. So if they're going to do that again in the next round and maybe try and catch him off guard, it has to work, because then their money's going to get dropped down to zero, then they're going to have to save, and then all of a sudden TyLoo's back into it. And then you just don't want to give TyLoo the chance in that sense.
No, 7-1 right now, G2. I mean, they still have a pretty comfortable lead going. And wow, okay. A flawless round. Body not able to do anything over here in the sewers. So 7-2, TyLoo, that's it. They finally break the streak.
Yeah, but still, you have to say that we're still gonna have to see something out of TyLoo, because that round it was G2 bringing the fight to them. It wasn't any kind of tactical changeup from the TyLoo side. They just kind of waited and capitalized on those pushes. They just punished all of them. So now, I mean, if G2 with the double op setup, you got to imagine, yeah, they can take some more aggressive angles, but overall, more than likely, this setup is gonna be a little bit farther back. So TyLoo, this is where they have to be the creative ones.
Curious. Okay, Shox is gonna go for the sewers kind of push here with the AWP. He's got RPK to back him, but look at this TyLoo. They're all grouped up outside of Monster. They can just try and rush right around the defense. RPK and Shox. Shox, if he can find DD, not going to go for the peek, but DD had the bomb. That would have thrown a wrench in things. Instead, it's RPK who's going to look for the quick flank. Now, I mean, the push begins. Body, he's going to be able to stay alive. He finds the headshot on Captain Mo. That's some solid work. So a man advantage now for G2 going into the retake. Bomb has not been planted yet. They're still finding the space here to actually get the security to plant that bomb. TyLoo, they're not quite managing it until DD finds a shot on body, brings it back to a 3-on-3, and they should be able to get a plant here, except Smith is there to drop DD. Just non-stop action here. It's like 30 seconds straight of fight, all-out brawl on this B site. Somebody stop this man.
And Fancy's had great positioning in water this whole time, and that's kind of prevented G2 from getting a little bit more aggressive and trying to stamp this out. But yeah, the bomb not being planted is crazy. It did seem like there was some miscommunication, DD maybe not realizing he had it, because he stayed away from that execute for so long. And you were right, if Shox gets that pick, that might be over. And there's a good find. Now it puts Fancy into a 1-on-2, and still this bomb hasn't gone down.
Does he realize where the second man is? This is all going to come down to Shox. And of course, you can count on Shox to pull it through. Nice headshot there. Keeps his cool. Saves the AWP as well. And that, well, I mean, it was kind of a short story there for TyLoo. You start believing, perhaps, in the dream, but it's 8-2 now for G2.
Yeah, but it's okay, because they won the other round so cleanly, their second round, they had all five players survive. They can reinvest in this one even without the plant, and now you start to look at G2's money. They've got three players below $1,000, so if they're to lose this round, TyLoo still has that chance. They're kind of have G2 on the breaking point. I think there'd be one more buyout of G2, but it would be a little bit weak, but there's still a window of opportunity here, and that's a good start. More aggression from G2 gets punished.
Very clever. Stuff, just the positioning. Not a huge fan of the rechallenge. Scream bangs his head off. Captain Mo is down. Fancy gonna catch body going overly aggressive. He's trying to create some space exactly for Shoxi, but then Scream gets caught. This is just back and forth. What is going on in these last two rounds? Just kill after kill. Both teams trading.
Yeah, this is starting to get a little bit messy just because of all the aggression that G2 has that doesn't seem to have rhyme or reason. It's more just like push your spot and win the battle. And now it's timing for RPK, and he's going to hold it, and he's going to win it. DD not even expecting that whatsoever. Attacker's up next, and he knows where RPK is. First time a kill hasn't been traded in this round. It gives G2 a 2-on-1 advantage, all on somebody.
RPK, his style is just so mechanical. It's so crisp when he gets his aim in there. And now, Shox, exactly, misses the shot, but he gives it away, and now he knows somebody that he's boxed in. He has to win this duel versus RPK, and it's just not going to happen. RPK survives with 13 HP, 3 kills to his name, pretty much. What, single-handedly just carrying it through there at the end for G2, because beginning of this was just chaos.
Yeah, just hectic. And I mean, who better than RPK, Mr. Reliable, like the typical anchor for G2 on these bomb sites, to just be chilling there, just waiting, getting his triple kill, casual, calm, good stuff.
Yeah, much like us.
Yeah, very much like us.
Okay, so I mean, yes, 9-2, economy broken now for TyLoo. This is a tactical pause from TyLoo as well. Yeah. Second one of them of theirs for the half. I'm glad to see teams actually making use of these 30-second timeouts, because it's not like the long timeout that you could have before, 2 minutes, where you could really just put a halt to things. Mm-hmm. You have to be a little bit more open about when you use these 30 seconds. But if you're at TyLoo's shoes right now, Moses, you having, you know, competed star player of your team only a decade ago, but still, you know, like, what would you be saying?
It's been a short decade. I'm actually kind of interested. I would like to see. The hard part is, if you're TyLoo, the big question you're saying is, you maybe want to try and do something fast because you really haven't had too many fast tactics that you've brought out. But like this default, this far back style that they want to play, that's like the counter to all this aggression from G2. So it's supposed to be working, but it's not. So you almost have to abandon it at a certain point. And then the tough part for TyLoo is they've kind of missed that window of opportunity to break the economy. Body again going for a push. It's deja vu from last round.
Why?
Why not, I think, is the better question. Why not? Maybe they want to give Scrim another chance for an ace.
Why not? You're right. For TyLoo, I mean, chance is going to come. There's another clean kill. 7 bullets left. There's another one. Ah, it ends this time. Scream, not able to pull it through, but still 3 kills for him. 900 bucks in his pocket, and attacker has got an M4 with no Kevlar. Smith manages to chase him out of the restrooms there. You know, he had some of that Mexican food, needed to get in there quick.
when you got to go, you got to go.
You got to go. Not going to get in the way. 18-0-8 for Scream. A lot of those, keep in mind, what, like 8 of those at least are anti-eco kills.
Yeah.
So, you know.
The ace and then those 2 or 3 that we just saw just now. So, yeah. 10-2, though, and this is the tough part. I mean, G2 really hasn't had to worry about money this entire thing. I mean, they win pistol and they've just been steamrolling. So, not even really worried about the economy, even though it is still kind of low. I'm quite, like, this is the point now where you know there's a buy coming out for TyLoo. So, if I'm G2, I calm down the aggression a little bit. Mm-hmm. Yep. And at least this time they have 2 players pushing towards sandbags, right? It's not just that 1 player body just rushing through monster.
Yeah, RPK and body actually with a bit of a clever positioning there. RPK boosted up on sandbags, so if somebody were to peek from connector, might go south for them. Smith was posted up at long with that AWP, and Shox continues to go for the aggression. They're just, yeah, walking right around each other. Surprise, surprise. And somebody's going to win the duel versus Shox.
Yeah, well, now the tough part, Smith's is rotating back, but he's got the AWP. He can't be overextended with this challenge. He kind of just has to hold the angle. He's the only one here slowly creeping out. Oh, that's an unfortunate miss, but he's going to get the follow-up. Somebody trying to make it happen. The bomb is still very far away, so they have to commit to this A hit. I think they're just trying to find a pick here, but the danger is Scream. Yeah, he's on the flank, and that's going to be tough for them to deal with, especially considering everyone's going to be confused since Captain Moe is in the stairwell.
Woo-hoo! Good night, Scream. That sucks for you, but Captain Moe's going to get caught. That's RPK finding that kill on the B site. That donates the bomb to G2, and now it's all on Fancy.
Yeah, these mid-round hits that TyLoo has, they just feel so disorganized, don't they? It seems like there's not like a clear voice saying this is what we're doing, because they have 2 players attacking the A site. That's a good kill from Fancy. He's actually even going to dodge the op shot, but he's got a big job to do. I mean, a bomb plant here would be great, but very little chance of him winning with body this quick on the flank, spamming the smoke, and he just finds it right through.
Yeah, immediately done there by body with the kit. Quick defuse coming through, and again, 2 players surviving for G2. Smith with the AWP, that's pretty solid as well. And yeah, I mean, it does look a bit disjointed. You're right, TyLoo, at least they've got the body system in that mid situation.
I mean, look at the mini map right now. 2 players at A, 1 in the stairwell, 1 all the way back towards T spawn, still even watching for pushes. And I mean, if you're going to be that far back watching for pushes and flanks, if there's going to be a player, I think that was Scream that had the flank up stairwell. Like, if that's going to happen, then there's just no point for you being back there. So if they're going to be that spread out, they have to make sure that their players being aggressive on a bomb site can't get flanked and backstabbed like that.
Well, we'll see. I mean, 2 rounds left in this first half. 11-2 for G2. Massive lead on the CT side. And you're right. There's only 2 chances left here for TyLoo to actually try and make something out of this half. If G2 get up to 13-2, it's going to be looking a little hairy for him here. So AKs, handful of nades, and this time around they are moving pretty slowly, G2, or at least TyLoo rather. They do actually manage to clear out as a pair connector. Now they have control of that part of the map. They've reconnected with the bomb in mid.
But they don't have a lot of utility on the TyLoo
side. What's going on with Fancy?
He's back towards T-spawn. That's what he was doing last round as well. I think he's just throwing some late nades to deny information or cause some kind of a presence. But they don't have the utility to kind of spend on this. This is why you'd hope that they would just be much more grouped up and just you have to trade in this situation. That's what this round is going to come down to, if TyLoo can trade. So now Scream, he's got 1 kill on Captain Moe, and that flashbang is going to slow things down. But still, TyLoo just don't seem like they want to get aggressive here. They don't want to pounce on any of these opportunities.
They're really playing. They're really drawing this out. 40 seconds left on the clock now. And well, TyLoo, four players alive. Ooh, barely. Somebody gets tagged, legged by Smith. That was a quick one. And there's the retreat peek from Smith. It was actually effective. Very nice flash. And now he's going to get to look the mid. Misses the flick. Gets caught. Fancy. That's a key kill. That's going to open things up. Shoxy, though. Instant return. Drops attacker. And now the push begins here for TyLoo. They've got 20 seconds left to get this bomb plant. And somebody just getting kills. But then Scream shows up. Takes out two. And it's all on DD in a 1v3. He's stuck in the corner as well. He's going to have to fight his way out. And it's not going to happen. Scream will find him eventually. Quad kill for Scream at the end of the key round here. 12-2.
Yeah, that's a nice defense. Good play from Shox as well. He gets that initial kill, and then he knows he doesn't have the angle to re-peek into it. He knows he's got two players of TyLoo, so he just plays it passively, waits for them to commit into the site, because he knows the reinforcements are coming. Even though he falls, it's not a big deal. But yeah, just too much damage taken from TyLoo before that hit comes in. I mean, you have to be a little bit more assertive than that, especially when you don't have the utility. You can't let Smith leg somebody and get away with it. Now, he was in an awkward spot, so he does eventually get caught. But still, if you're TyLoo, that's got to be a little bit more swarming of an attack, because you have to have those trades.
Yeah, that is always a little bit of a tough position to find yourself in if you're Smith. It's a bit of a one-and-done spot if you don't have mid control.
For anyone who gets caught there. I mean, we've seen some spectacular things, but it's such a disadvantage if you're caught in that, being pinched from two different sides. It's so hard to peek from that sign position, especially with an AWP, with the slow rate of fire.
So let's see how things progress here. Once again, they've laid a trap. Fancy waiting outside a monster, waiting for body to go for the peak, but that's not going to happen this time around. They're playing it very calm on the B side. Instead, it's Smith pushing all the way up to top long. If he gets the bomb here, if he wins this duel versus somebody, this is going to be huge. Picks up the shot, easily done. That drops the bomb, and that really messes everything up here for TyLoo. Shox is going to find a kill. They are maintaining the man advantage now as G2 trades all over the place, but still, TyLoo, with 50 seconds left, have to run all the way back practically to T-spawn to pick up the bomb.
Yeah, and this is now a tough situation, because they did gain some progress towards bathrooms. That bomb being all on its own, that's kind of crippled them here, and they've got to spend so much time. You can see DD even being cautious, so even more time coming down off the clock. Now we see aggression from Shox. He's pushed up towards bathrooms. He's going to be in an awkward position, so all this work they've done to clear out bathrooms initially is pretty much gone to waste because of how long it's taken, because they've had to go back to get the bomb.
25 seconds left. Easy shot. Shoxy sees the shadow on the ground, just allows him to line it up nice and neat. Attacker is now in a 1v3. He has to go back to pick up the bomb. 15 seconds left, counting down. Shoxy's going to be there with a nade out. That's not good. Attacker will kill him, but it's not going to be good enough. Body rotating over from the B site will end this half. 13-2 now, and that is just a fantastic start for G2. Great bounce back from them after the catastrophe that happened on Kabul. We're going to take a short break here before we get into the second half, so don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, from that short break. We're going to get into the second half here. G2 are currently in the process of stomping TyLoo into the ground. Unfortunately for TyLoo, the dragon, it came without its fangs today. Moses, what's going on here?
It's a weak dragon. It's a weak dragon somewhere.
Yeah, but dragons are supposed to be like epic, legendary. And then I get, oh, it's like the Game of Thrones dragon?
Yeah, it's like Game of Thrones. You've waited like four seasons to see the dragon, and then they don't really do anything the first time you see him, so.
Ah, yeah, it's kind of true. I mean, they managed to qualify for Oakland, but right now it's not going too hot here for TyLoo, although Captain Mo and Fancy are doing some work. Bonnie going to be able to bring it back to a 3-on-3 here in the pistol round. 13-2 lead, and G2 right now, they're just picking them apart. TyLoo, what can you do?
Yeah, I mean, you can see it's they kind of lose these rounds. They don't have bad starts. Even on their T side, they didn't necessarily have bad starts. It's when it gets into these 3-on-3s, these mid-round situations, that you really see the game sense kind of let them down. When you can see G2 with this individual capability of all these players is just overwhelming.
Decisions here. Body going to clear out connector. DD is just waiting for this. Oh, perfectly done. Closes the door behind him.
So
no
polite.
Chance for DD. Yeah. Well, you know, that's French school, you know. Learn manners. Body, definitely head of his class.
Well, I've got a tough... Actually, I mean, it seems like just randomly this mobility from DD has actually worked out for him in the end. Shox thought he was flanking all the way around through T-spawn. It's the wrong assumption. That allows Body to go down. But why is he still chasing? Why is he still going after Shox? This doesn't need to happen. 30 seconds left, and you've now put your teammate in a one-on-one against one of the best players in the world.
Yeah, pistol players. Now it all comes down to the luck of the draw. Is he looking the right way? Shox, he does recover, but attacker will find the headshot instead. There was a moment there where I thought Shoxy was going to be looking towards short. He was just taken to the side of the head without knowing. But that is actually like a feather in your cap. You just clutched against Shoxy.
Yeah.
That's not something that happens every day. Shoxy is a monster.
Yeah, but this play, this is the thing. Those are the small mistakes that, yeah, in this round, it's okay. It works out. But like when you have that, you know, if you play that out 10 times, maybe Shox wins 6 of them. And you just can't have those kind of mistakes from DD. And those are the things that they're going to have to learn against some of these better teams, because more than likely they get away with that in their region when they're playing some of the Chinese teams and the Asian teams. But here against G2, that's going to punish you later on. And actually, DD, the timing again almost works out against him, but he recovers. He is traded off, and now this B bomb site is going to be under heavy attack.
No, Smith is alone, though. That's ugly. They're worrying about connector instead of just pushing up onto the site. Well, RPK is going to be able to find a kill on somebody, but attacker is here. Still manages to make this a very close round. 2-2 now. 2 versus 2, rather, and they've got a rifle to work with. Instant headshot there from Body, but he's not going to confirm the kill. Fancy survives. 8 HP left on him, and while that smoke is still up, what is going on?
Oh, the TK.
Are you, what?
No, Captain Mo. Oh, that is unfortunate. That's painful.
It's like watching a car crash happen.
You can't look away.
You can't look away.
I was wondering why Captain Mo like wasn't shooting at him.
I'm now going to have that in my mind for like the rest of my life. Right? I'm never going to forget that sort of scenario. It's like scarred in there now. What? That's unfortunate.
Yeah, that's the nicest way we can put it, and should try and be nice. Well, RPK, the M4 is salvaged from him, so he's happy about it. That's a nice 1-on-2 that he can win. Probably the easiest 1-on-2 you'll ever get. And G2, they're actually, I mean, unlike the first half, they're playing this a little bit passive, a little bit more cautiously. They're starting to move up in bathrooms and take that over. There's a stack towards the B bomb site for TyLoo. Fancy has just come back towards A, but really, I mean, this is just kind of a blindly incorrect call for TyLoo.
We no longer have the cams, right, on TyLoo or G2, because you can't actually see like real life violence, like physical violence, because like, the guy, like Mo, just got slapped so hard by his teammates. Like, what are you doing?
Oh.
4v4 now. G2 with the SMGs, 2 rifles though, and Smith just gets obliterated by Fancy. That was well done with the CZ up close. Big damage being dealt, and with 50 seconds left on this clock, we're into a 3-on-3.
Yeah, but here's the patience of G2. Use the utility you have. I mean, DD obviously trying to make a play. That might be a little bit of frustration coming through for the TyLoo side, but just use it, get the bomb planted, and now like you can see, I mean, they're setting up great positions.
Yeah, solid after plant now for Fancy, and RPK, he's not playing around. Both rifles survive it, and that's a 15-3 scoreline now for G2. Match point for them, and it's a force-buy scenario here for TyLoo.
Every round is a force-buy scenario for TyLoo now.
Fair. Fair.
Everything is force-buy. the benefit of this is like, well, I mean, maybe not benefit. I should say the silver lining, perhaps, is that two versus one, that's such a disaster. I mean, that hurts a lot more if this ends up in like a 16-14 or 16-12 loss. Mm-hmm. The fact that it's such a blowout, I mean, they can get past that kind of an issue pretty quickly.
Let's see, Bonnie, they're taking point, opens it up, two kills for him, and that's perfectly fine. He did his job. Now it's up to his teammates here to just restore order, and somehow somebody gets two kills, the perfect flank. Smith's will be the one to end it, however. It is a 16-3 scoreline at the end. G2, well, showing that they are perfectly capable of doing what Immortals did to them on Cobble. You know, they go up against TyLoo and just destroy them.
Yeah, the individuals